Julie, no, you, like, really? You're about to throw away comma control to Lesu?
I don't have comma control. I'm on the bottom of comma control. I'm ready to jump ship. I'm ready to jump ship.
Oh. Are you okay?
Oh my God, she lost her damn mind.
Thank you, Lord. Cover us. Get that item going. Put them out there somewhere tomorrow. I'm serious. I'm not touching it.
Joanna doesn't like the immunity idol because she thinks that it is an idol. And idols are forbidden via the Ten Commandments, right? Thou shalt have no other gods before me. She didn't want it in the camp at all. She doesn't want to touch it. She doesn't want to hold it. She wants nothing to do with it.
Why can't you look at it as a symbol instead of an idol?
Because it's not. It's called an idol for a reason.
Well,
it's almost
let's
like,
change the name.
No, I can't do
but
that.
But it meant that we were unified and we...
No, you don't understand.
You know, some people worship Buddha and some people do that or whatever. I worship the Most High El Elyon God, Jehovah Jireh, El Shaddai, and he despises idol worship. If you read the Old Testament, they got struck down, and that's why we got rained on last night, bringing the idol into our tribe.
That idol is the reason why we're all here right now.
That idol is not because we're all here. We won before we had the idol. As soon as we lose the idol. So if the idol is our friend, why isn't he with us when we're going doing bad?
I'll shoot you straight. Let's stop and talk.
Let's stop and talk, man.
You're too big of a threat.
Okay.
I like you. I think
to the group or a threat to you?
When this thing goes, it's your personality, your great looks. That's a threat. When I make my decision, I've got four children at home and a wife, and that's what I base my decisions on. You are so freaking dangerous, man.
So if I had kids, would that alter your decision? Is that what you're telling me?
No, I'm saying if you had kids, you'd be playing the game and understanding
like you? I'd be playing a game like you if I had kids.
I've known you for what now? 5 days.
5 days. 5 days.
I've got a family at home. I've known you a long time.
Who else is a threat, T?
Anybody that's playing the game.
Yeah.
Anybody that's in this game. There were 17 threats when we started this game. 17 threats. Only one person wins.
Oh man, look at the crevice of the rocks. They got K-bar like knives. They got wedding stones.
Yeah. It was like awkward silence, crickets chirping. Then Cowboy launches into this huge like speech about Chinese symbology or something.
In our culture, we revere the dog, the horse, the turtle, and the dragon. Those are the four creatures that we revered. Okay, every time if you look at your life, you'll find a lot of dragons and monkeys and rat friends. If you got dragons or rat and monkeys, you find a lot of your men. That's the dog. The second one is the horse. So in wartime, the horse helped the soldier defend the nation. And peacetime helped with transportation. They said they see there's two more. Giant turtle, as big as this whole area. Giant.
After a while of just listening to him talk over and over and over and over again, it was a little bit much. And we were kind of like all looking around at each other like, okay, is he gonna stop talking?
We wanna harvest some noni, if you guys don't mind. We don't have any noni. People are hurting all over.
Philip, give us some insight. A situation like this, what do you do to be successful?
Well, the Bushido code was how a samurai knew how he had to conduct his life when he was facing difficult circumstances. And they had a whole strategy about the task at hand. And they shamed their feudal lord. They would have to cut themselves. That was one of the things that they looked for. They looked for you to make the first move. And then they would strike. And the Bushido code gave them a way to live, as the Bible for Matt has given him a way to live. And I know he knows it's all up here. And as long as he keeps that focus, he'll do just fine.
Thanks, Philip.
Hey, girl. Hey. We'll have a few minutes because I should not be talking.
Okay.
I'm going to get in trouble, probably.
Okay.
So they're throwing your name out there.
Okay.
But I'm the only person. I just wanted to be upfront with you.
Yeah.
Because I've gotten nothing but amazingness from you.
Yeah.
And I tried. I thought I had a different boat. We were locked in on someone, and then I come back, and they're flipped again.
I just would rather tell you than have you be blindsided.
You're such a big heart, and, like, I just respect you enough as a person. But, like, I just didn't want this to
be. I really appreciate that. You have no idea what that means to me.
And I just figured the more information you have, because I'd rather see you here tomorrow than some of these people, but.
All right, I'm gonna go back. You can. Elizabeth, I'm just. No, it's okay. I'm good. And I really do appreciate it. I'm sorry, girl.
I feel like I'm grounded.
Huh.
When it's a rainy day and I'm just having to sit in my grandma's sewing room.
Be quiet.
Yeah. I have a poem to share with you all. It's called God's Grandeur. It's by Gerard Manley Hopkins. The world is charged with the grandeur of God. It will flame out like shining from shook foil. It gathers to a greatness like the ooze of oil crushed. Why do men then now not wreck his rod? And for all this, nature is never spent. There lives the dearest freshness deep down things, because the Holy Ghost over the bent world broods with warm breasts and with, bright wings.
Nice.
Yay!
Very nice.
You should do that every day for us.
I don't know if I've got 18 poems.
Fishback's poem of the day.
I genuinely like my new tribe. I feel really bad that I'm doing this. It's just that I know in their agenda it was to kill these chickens, and obviously I have my own agenda. So I finally did my plan of releasing the chickens. They're free. Their lives are saved.
Yeah, I know it's kind of cold, but it's better than being fried rice in the morning.
This is my master plan. I'm ecstatic. I just have to head back now, go to sleep, and pretend, oh, well, we're chickens. I'm so happy.
Heidi, do you have any conditioner?
No.
Shot down by another woman.
Daniel.
Heidi, do you have any conditioner?
I already asked her if she has conditioner.
Daniel. You're thinking, you just want to have a little, have the conversation with Heidi that you want to have.
Yeah, just turn and conditioner. Say hi, dude.
All right, never mind. Forgive me, okay? Let's go on, okay?
Jean.
Do you have conditioner?
How did you guess?
Look how that cost you.
Damn it.
We are tied up again.
I owe you. Like, I think we just had a really good talk.
That's what I wanted, yeah.
That's not what you wanted.
That's not what I wanted,
right.
But
we just had a really good talk, and I feel a lot closer. Like, I actually feel like I'm part of them now. And so you.
Well, opening that up to them. To.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
No problem. Things are looking pretty bad. And I still think they're looking pretty bad.
Survivor is such a beautiful microcosm for the world. And we all come together, and the game-changing theme for the Tribal Council to have this open forum to bring us together to really express these ideas, these different ideas, and bring our different walks of life. It's a beautiful microcosm, and I think it's really amazing that it allowed us to actually choose the right person that won, Sarah. And it's a microcosm for the rest of the world that we all need to unite as a people to change the way the United States is going, and we need to make better decisions on how the United States is run.
All right, well, on that note.
I miss you.
Good. I don't know.
You guys are gonna hate us.
No, I love it.
Love it.
Are you kidding me? So cute. Jacqueline and John are in love. You know, it was kind of like I was watching a honeymoon. I'm totally jealous. I'm sitting here, single, 20, hanging out with my mom. Mom and I are both single.
Man, it's like that time of day when you're like, uh-huh. My mom has made her share of mistakes. She's been married 3 times and divorced 3 times. My time will come. My mom's next time will come.
Anything you go to do in Africa's tough. And then here you are in camp with a powder puff.
We can pop some corn.
The first thing I had to do was just ask him straight up and get it off my shoulders and get the burden out. Well, you'll have to tell me a little bit more about your lifestyle, because I got a lot of questions to ask you.
About what?
Well, are you,
About me being gay?
Well, are you open? Are you gay?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
I am.
See, when I saw you, you know, we didn't know each other, I said, I think he's gay. And Vaughn said, gay? I said, yeah, I think he is. I said, he's pretty.
I
will be honest with you. I can't say as I've ever known a gay man. If it did, he was still in the closet. You know what I'm saying?
You know, that's probably it right there. A lot of people know him, they just don't know him.
I got in trouble in a college at a gay bar. I went in, didn't know it was gay.
Oh. And he was talking about something, and he had gone to a gay bar or something. I don't even know. I really wasn't paying that much attention to him.
Well, let's cook. His nightfall's gonna be here in front of us tomorrow. If you have any more logs, just put them on top, because that's going to burn out again. Can you put that log right on top?
Who's going to put that?
Wait, they have to go on rocks. They can't go on wood, you guys. They can't go on wood. I thought we had rocks in there.
We do.
That's what they're for, right?
JP is very demanding, and I think he does it in a very sly way. Where if you're not very observant, you wouldn't even realize that he's being controlling. But just the way he was sitting in camp today, like all sprawled out with his back against the like recliner on the throne, and everyone's just like waiting on him.
Harvard came in the shit.
Where is it? Oh yeah. He's very demanding. He's like, oh, hand me that machete. Oh, hand me this bowl. You know, serve me. I'm like, no, that just doesn't fly with me at all.
I'm just pissed because I said, dude, what's that?
Yeah, I can't believe you did that.
But I didn't touch it first.
What the hell, Reem? You just gave it to someone else.
Do you think that I gave this away? Like, you think I'm that freaking stupid? I wanted that, but he touched it first, and the rules are the rules. Those two get on my damn nerves, man.
You just accused me of giving away an advantage. Do I have complete idiot written on my forehead?
I don't even know what to say.
You just said I gave it to him. Don't you tell me I gave something away.
Well, you point at it, and then he picks it up and runs away.
You got the biggest mouth in the whole country.
Reem.
You're the one that said I gave him the advantage. By saying that, you've lit off a volcano, bro.
It is a disaster here. It truly is the most dysfunctional family I've ever met.
I don't need zero.
Then why are you talking about it?
Because you're getting on my nerves. And it's 12 days of listening to the bull, and I'm done with it.
The worst part of it all, no one knows how long this train wreck can last. That's a scary situation because people are legitimately losing it.
Reem, that's
all. Shut
up. It's so different having a community. Like an individual that is in group.
Ah,
whoa, sorry. Sorry, are you okay?
Well, I'm.
Are you okay?
I mean, I'm not gonna die.
I have a good idea. I'm gonna tell all of you guys.
What is it?
My idea is if the jury's 7, which I think we're all assuming that it is, this is the last spot that wouldn't make the jury. What I'm proposing is I know that I'm assuming I'm on the chopping block tonight. That's fine. I didn't think I'd come this far at all. Like, I totally didn't think I would. I would like it if I could be an honorary jury member that doesn't get a vote at all, but I would like to stay and watch.
We get back from the immunity challenge, and Eric tells us he has this really bright idea. He says, I'm gonna propose to Jeff tonight that I'm an honorary jury member, because he's really upset for not making the jury. But, you know, the jury could start tonight, I don't know, but he's really upset.
I know the rules are strict on this, and I know the rules are really tight on this, but...
Not a
we don't have that
but like it, us. It could be, if I stand up and say, do you all agree to this? If everybody says yeah, then I can stay. I think they would
we'll
have to.
Propose it tonight, and we'll stand by you.
I want to, and I want you guys to stand by me when that happens.
So I guess we're going to partition tonight, let Eric sit in on tribal councils for the rest of the time here or something.
That's my good idea.